I'm so lonely, broken angel. I'm so lonely, listen to...
Cast it as reform, the degree to which Xi Jinping is recreating what looks to many like a cult of personality. He's investing power not just in the centralized Communist Party, but in himself and his closest associates. That, surely, is reminiscent of Mao.
First of all, personality cult doesn't work in China. Then it will not be helpful for anyone in China, including President Xi Jinping. On the other hand, I think a stronger leader, a more centralized leadership, given China's circumstances and challenges today, may not be a bad thing for China. So it really depends on whether we look more profoundly into the realities in China.
Well, the realities in China is something you know well because you live there. I mean, for example, this new app that many millions of Chinese have been required to download and use in the last few months, it's called the Study the Great Nation app, and it is devoted, let us be honest, to promoting the image of Xi Jinping. You're a very respected academic. Have you downloaded and then filled in the Study the Great Nation app?
Personally, I have not downloaded this app at all. Secondly, I would say that the fact that there are more than 100 Xi Jinping thought institutions or research academies being set up in recent years probably more reflect the emotions of the leaders on the second tier or even third tier who really want to create the impression that they really love Xi Jinping, for example, rather than the personal preferences of President Xi Jinping himself.
The way in which you get points for showing your knowledge of Xi Jinping and his greatness, it's part of a much bigger picture, isn't it, in which the Chinese government is using its dominant presence online in China to surveil, monitor, and indeed judge the citizens of the country. And the government is going to launch this national social credit system online in which you are given points for showing behaviors which are to the liking of the Communist Party. And if you behave in ways that the Communist Party regards as antisocial, you will lose credits and ultimately you will be punished. Are you happy to live in that kind of country?
Well, first of all, I think a monitoring by the government of the social behavior of the people does exist in China. There are quite a few aspects of that which I personally do not like.
200 million surveillance cameras, more than four times as many as in the United States.
Yeah, in a sense, in China, if you walk around, etc., you will be monitored, that's for sure. However, on the other hand, allow me to emphasize one point. I think the overall priority of such monitoring is still to make the society safer and more stable.
Well, why don't you like it then?
Well, sometimes it could be very intrusive. Sometimes it impacts on people's privacy, etc. It's like a choice between two evils, and the government in China apparently choose the so-called lesser evil to follow. Eventually, I hope, the government can be more sophisticated in achieving their goals of anti-terrorism, anti-extremism, or anti-separatism, for example, and people can have a freer atmosphere to operate in, and they can view, for example, websites from abroad or watch BBC, for example. I believe one day that day will come.
Yes, I just wonder why you think it is not coming right now and why China is building this extraordinary infrastructure of what can only be described as a big brother society. Why do you think it is doing it today?
Well, in a sense, yes, indeed, especially with internet technologies, for example, the government can achieve much higher efficiency in monitoring the society. However, as I just now mentioned, the overall prevailing priority is still to prevent, for example, the country plunging into instability.
I'm so lonely, broken.